when you will call on me, come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 12. Hear us, my tongue compelled. Hear us. United States President Franklin D. Roosevelt often endured a long receiving line at the White House. As the story is told, he complained that no one is paying attention to what he said. So, he decided to experiment at a reception. To everyone who passed down the line and shook hands, he said, "I murdered my grandmother this morning." The guest responded with a phrase like, "Marvelous. Keep up the good work. God bless you, sir." It wasn't until the end of the line greeting the ambassador from Bolivia that his words were actually heard. Nonetheless, the ambassador whispered, "I'm sure he had it coming." Do you wonder if people are really listening? Or worse, do you fear that God isn't listening? We can tell if people are listening based on their response or eye contact. But how do we know if God is listening? Should we rely on feelings or see if God answers our prayers? After 70 years of exile in Babylon, God promised to bring his people back to Jerusalem and secure their future. Jeremiah chapter 29 verses 10 and 11. When they called upon him, he heard them, and they knew that God heard their prayers because he promised to listen. And the same is true for us. 1 John chapter 5 verse 14. We don't need to rely on our feelings or wait for a sign to know that God listens to us. He's promised to listen, and he always keeps his promises. 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 20. Let us reflect and pray. When have you felt that God wasn't listening? Why did you feel that way? A prayer. Dear God, thank you for hearing my prayers. Though I may not sometimes doubt it, help me to trust your promise that you listen to me. Amen. Be blessed beyond. My beloved brethren, I earnestly beseech your support to sending stars or buying physical and digital products from the link on the description box. Thank you very much, and be blessed beyond.